Now that you have entered class 10, your heartbeat might have increased. Not only students, but parents, teachers, and headmasters are also worried about the result of class 10. This is a stage wherein the student dreams of really achieving high. Now let me remind you here that dreaming alone will not help you to achieve your goals, but your continuous efforts will help you to achieve success. Because success is the sum of all the efforts which you make day in and day out. So my dear students, don't waste even a single day and continuously make efforts to succeed. And in all your efforts, your math facilitator Divya will be with you. And now let us start our preparation for class 10 with chapter 1, real numbers. This would be an introductory video where I would teach you the concepts of this chapter and problems we shall solve in the later videos. Now let's quickly get started. Now before talking about real numbers and the different types of number systems which you have already learned earlier, let us talk about Euclid's division lemma. Okay, now firstly let me take an example. Now you know how to divide numbers, so let us divide 12 by 4. Okay, so how do you do it? So you write it in this way, 12 divided by 4, and you know that 4 threes are 12, subtracting you get the remainder 0. Yes, now this is called divisor. Now this 4 is called as divisor, and this 12 is called as dividend, and 3 is called quotient, and this 0 here it is called remainder. Now the number by which you want to divide is called divisor, and the number which you are going to divide is called dividend, and the answer which you get after the division process you call it as quotient, and this is called as remainder. So now I will represent this in the form of equation. How? So you can see that dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Do you agree? So dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, so now let us take another example. Say 16 divided by 5. Okay, so here 5 threes are 15 and you are left out with remainder 1. Okay, this also can we write it in this form. So here dividend is 16 is equal to divisor is 5 into quotient is 3 plus the remainder is 1. Yes, so 5 threes are 15 plus 1 gives you the dividend 16. Okay, now let us express this in general form. So if a and b are any positive integer, then there exist q and r. These are whole numbers such that a is equal to bq plus r. Okay, now here a is nothing but dividend, b is the divisor, q is quotient, and r is remainder. Okay, so when a is dividend and b is divisor, then there exist a quotient and a remainder satisfying this equation. Clear? Now always you can see that the remainder lies between two numbers, 0 and b. B is nothing but the divisor. Yes, the remainder is always greater than or equal to 0, and it is always less than the divisor. Okay, so in this case you can see that remainder is 0. Clear? And in this case you can see that remainder is 1. Now 1 is a number less than 5. 1 is less than divisor. So always remainder is less than divisor, or it takes values between 0 and b. Okay, so the condition is 0 is less than or equal to r is less than b, where r is the remainder and b is the divisor. Okay, let us check this condition with another example. Suppose if you want to divide 24 divided by 5. Yes, here divisor is 5. Now so you know that 5 4s are 20 and the remainder is 4. Yes, so you can see that the remainder is always less than the divisor. So you can take any number of examples and check, and you always find that the remainder is less than the divisor. Clear? So this condition satisfies for any positive integers. Okay, so if a and b are positive integers, then there exists a quotient and a remainder, and the remainder always satisfies the condition 0 less than or equal to r less than बी वेयर बी इज डिवाइजर एंड दीज फोर टर्म्स कैन बी रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू बी क्यू प्लस आर. नाउ दिस इक्वेशन विच यू हैव रिटन हियर इज कॉल्ड एज यूक्लिड्स डिविजन लेम्मा. दो यू नो दिस कंडीशन, दो यू नो ऑल दिस डिविजन प्रोसेस, बट स्टिल यू आर नॉट अवेयर दैट दिस इज कॉल्ड एज यूक्लिड्स डिविजन लेम्मा. नाउ लेट मी स्टेट यूक्लिड्स डिविजन लेम्मा वंस अगेन. इफ ए एंड बी आर टू पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स देन देयर एग्जिस्ट अ कोशेंट एंड रिमाइंडर विच सैटिस्फाइज दिस कंडीशन. A is equal to BQ plus R, where A is the dividend, B is divisor, Q is quotient and R is remainder. And always the remainder satisfies this condition, 0 less than or equal to R less than B. Clear, this is called Euclid's division lemma. And Euclid's division lemma is useful for finding the HCF and LCM of numbers. Now let us see how can we do that. Now if I want to find the HCF of two numbers, say HCF of 50 and 70, if I want to find out, then how do we do that? So you'll divide 50 by 70, yes, and you say that 50 ones are 50 and now 20 is a remainder. The remainder is less than the divisor. So what do? You write 50 here, yes, and then you see that 20, 2s are 40 and 10 is a remainder. Yes, again you write 20, you bring down 20 here and 10 twos are 20. Okay, and since the remainder is 0, you'll stop here and you'll say that 10 is a HCF of 50 and 70. Yes, the same thing if you want to do it in prime factorization method. How do we do it? So simply you'll find the factors of 50 and you'll find the factors of 70. Yes, prime factors. Now 50, prime factors of 50 is 2. Divides 50 25 times. Now 5 divides 25 5 times and 5 ones up. So it is 2 into 5 into 5 are the prime factors of 50. Now for 70, it is 2 divides 70 35 times and then 5 divides 35 7 times and 7 divides 7 1 times. Okay, so it is 2 into 5 into 7. Yes, now how do you find the HCF? HCF is nothing but firstly you'll find the common factors in both the things. Okay, so here you have 2 and 2. So write 2 here. And here you have 5 and 5. So you'll write 5. Okay, so you'll just check for the common factors and you will write down the common factors here. So HCF is product of this common factors. Yes, so 2 into 5 is 10. So HCF is 10. So in whichever method you do, you are getting the answer as 10. Now let us see for the same problem, for the same numbers, how can we find HCF using Euclid's division lemma. And not to forget, Euclid's division lemma is A is equal to BQ plus R, where 0 is less than or equal to R is less than B, and A is the dividend, B is divisor, Q is quotient and R is a remainder. Now let us check how can we find HCF of 50 and 70 using this method. So now the bigger number you'll take as A. Okay, so A is 70 first and B is 50. Okay, firstly we are taking A as 70 and B as 50. Okay, now substituting here, now A is 70. 70 is equal to what is B? B is 50. Now when you divide 50 by 70, what is the quotient you get? You get the quotient as 1. Yes, and what is the remainder you get? R remainder is 20. Yes, nothing but we have divided here. Let us do it here. So you are dividing 70 by 50. So 1 is the quotient and the remainder is 20. Yes, the same thing you can represent in this way. Yes, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. The same thing we have represented here. Now what we do is we move on to the next step. Okay, so here you will take 50 as A. Okay, so here A is 50. Okay, now you'll divide this 50 with 20. Clear? So A is 50 and B is 20. So let me write here. So this will be A and B in the next step. So here this is A. Now B is 20. Now when you divide 50 by 20, what do you get? So 22s are 40 and you are getting a remainder as 10. Yes? So quotient is 2 plus remainder is 10. Clear? Now here again this will be A and this will be B for the next step. Okay, so now 20 is equal to what is B? B is 10 into, if you divide 20 divided by 10, what do you get? 10 twos are 20 and the remainder is 0. Clear? So quotient is 2 plus remainder is 0. Okay, now when the remainder is zero, you'll stop your process here. Clear? And whatever the value of B you are getting here, this is called as HCF. Okay, so HCF is 10. Clear? So what did we do? Firstly, we have taken A as 70, the bigger number, and B as 50. Okay, and simply dividing, you brought it in the form of Euclid's division lemma. Okay, so dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Clear? Now for the next step, you are taking this as A, this will move here, and this number you are taking it as B. Clear? Now dividing this, you are getting some quotient and a remainder. Yes, the same thing you are writing in the form of Euclid's division lemma. So here dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Clear? Now for the third step, this will be A and this will be considered as B. Okay, so now 20 and 10. Clear? So 20 is equal to, if you divide, you will get it as 10 into 2 plus 0. Now when the remainder is 0, you will stop this process here, and whatever the value of B you are having here. Okay, this is nothing but A is equal to BQ plus R. Okay, when R is 0, when you have R as 0, then this value of B is called HCF. Okay, now here R is 0, so this value of B, this 10, is called HCF. And in whichever method you do, the HCF is same. Now this Euclid's division lemma can be extended to prove properties of numbers. Okay, now let us take one example. Now we have to show that a positive odd integer is of the form 4q plus 1, 4q plus 3. Okay, how do we do that? Now let the positive integer be A. Okay, I'm taking the positive odd integer as A. Now you know that A can be written as BQ plus R. Yes, so using this, now let us take B as 4. Now whatever you have here, the quotient, you can see that it is in the form of BQ plus R. BQ plus R, yes. So we'll compare these two things, okay. So comparing, you can see that B is what? B is 4. So you are taking B as 4, okay. Now, what is the condition for R? R is a number between 0 and B. Okay, 0 is less than or equal to R. R is less than B. Okay, now B is 4 here. So what is the condition? 0 is less than or equal to R, less than 4. Since B is 4, so R is less than 4. Okay, now what are the values R can take? R can take a value 0. Yes, since R is less than or equal to 0, so it can take 0 also. And R is 1, R can be 2, and R can also be 3. But R cannot be 4 since R should be less than 4. So using these conditions of R and substituting here, let us find the value of A. Okay, so now what is Euclid's division lemma? A is equal to BQ plus R. Yes, now let us substitute these values of R in this condition. Okay, so now case 1. When R equal to 0, let us take when R equal to 0, what happens to this? So A is equal to, what is B? B is 4, now this is Q, plus R is what? R is 0. So A is equal to 4Q. Clear? Now A is equal to 4Q can be written as 2 into 2Q. Yes, now a number is a multiple of 2, which means that this number is even. Yes, so this number is even, but we want odd number. Okay, we want a odd integer, so you cannot take R as 0. Now let us see what is R is 1. Now if in case 2, if R is equal to 1, then what happens to this condition? Now A is equal to B is what? B is 4, Q plus R is 1. Okay, and you can check that 4Q can be written as 2 into 2Q plus 1. Yes, so this is even plus 1. If you are adding 1 to even integer, you get a odd integer. Yes, so this condition is satisfied. So A is equal to 4Q plus 1 is satisfied. Now let us take case 3. What is case 3? In case 3, if R is equal to 2. Okay, now let us see what happens if R is 2. Now this is A is equal to B is 4Q plus R is 2. Yes, and now from this entire thing you can take 2 as common. Yes, so taking 2 as common, here you are left out with 2Q. Why? 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Yes, 4 you can write as 2 into 2. 1, 2 you are taking it as common. So you are left out with what? with another 2. So 2 cube plus, and here 2 is nothing but 2 into 1. Yes, you are taking 2 as common. So what are you left out with? 1. So now this is the final answer. Okay, now A is equal to 2 into something. Okay, so you can write as 2 into m. You can take 2 cube plus 1 as m. So A is 2m. 2m is nothing but an even integer. Yes, so this is even. So this condition is also false. Okay, so when r equal to 0, the condition is failing, and when r is equal to 2 also, the condition is failing. Okay, now let us check if r is equal to 3. Okay, when r is 3, what happens to this? A is equal to 4 cube plus 3. Yes, now here let us split 3. Now this can be written as 4 cube plus 2 plus 1. 3 I can write as 2 plus 1. Yes, now from this equation, take 2 as common. Okay, from these two terms, you take 2 as common. So 4 is nothing but 2 into 2. Taking 2 common, you are left out with 2 cube here, similar to this one. Yes. Plus, here 2 is nothing but 2 into 1, similar step. So, taking 2 common, you are left out with 1. Okay? And you have a plus 1. Yes? Now, this entire thing you can write as m, as you have written here. So, this is 2m plus 1. Okay? Now, 2m is even, and if you add 1 to this even number, you get a odd number. So, now clearly you can see that when r is 0, you are getting an even number. Yes? And when r is 2, you are getting an even number again. So, only these two conditions are satisfying. Yes, so you can say that a positive odd integer is of the form 4 cube plus 1 or 4 cube plus 3. And this is a very simple proof. Only thing you have to remember is you have to remember Euclid's division lemma. And the condition for r is very important so that you can take cases. Okay, and simple substitution, you will get the answer. This is a sure short question in your board exams. Now let us talk about fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay, now this theorem states that if x is a composite number, then x can be written as product of prime numbers. Okay, so it can be written as product of prime numbers like p1, p2, p3 and so on. So it can be stated as every composite number can be expressed as a product of prime numbers. Okay, and this product of prime numbers, this prime factorization is unique. The order of prime factors may change, but the factors are unique. Okay, now suppose if you take a number 24, yes, 24, you can factorize it in many ways. Like you can take as 2 12s are 24, yes, or you can take as 6 4s are 24. Okay, now these are factors of 24. Yes, you are factorizing 24 as 2 into 12 or 6 into 4. Now let us prime factor is 24. Now this 6 can be written as 2 into 3, yes, and 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Yes, now here also 12 can be written as 4 threes are, and 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Yes, so finally the prime factors are 2, 2, 2 and 3 in this case. Yes, so in this case 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 are the prime factorization of 24. Yes, and in this case also it is 2 into 3 into 2 into 2. Yes, if you see the number of 2s, count the number of 2s here, it is 1, 2, 3. Here it is also 1, 2, 3. Yes, and you have 1, 3 here and 1, 3 here. So 24, if you prime factorize it, you can prime factorize it on only one way. Yes, there is only one set of prime factors. It is 2 into 3 into 2 into 2. Yes, the order of it changed. Now you can see that the order of the prime factors changed, but the prime factors are unique. Yes, they are unique. Here also you have 3 2s. Here also you have 3 2s and 1 3. Yes, here also you have 3 2s and 1 3. The prime factors are unique, but the order can be changed. Okay, so every composite number can be expressed as product of prime factors. So this is called fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Now using fundamental theorem of arithmetic, let us find HCF and LCM of numbers. Okay, and using Euclid's division lemma, we have already found the HCF of numbers. So now let us see how can we find HCF and LCM using fundamental theorem of arithmetic. This is nothing but what you have learnt in your earlier classes. Okay, so what is fundamental theorem of arithmetic? It is nothing but a composite number can be expressed as product of primes. Okay, prime numbers has factors only 1 and the number itself. Yes, suppose if you take example 7, 7 is a prime number, yes. So 7 has how many factors? It is only 1 and the number itself. But if you take a composite number, it has different factors. Yes, it has factors more than 1 and itself, okay? More than 1 and itself, it has other factors also added to it. Clear? So that is composite number. So we are saying that that composite number can be expressed as product of prime factors, and this product of prime factors, the prime numbers which are involved in this product are unique. The order might be changed, but the prime numbers are unique. This we have learned with examples, yes. So now let us see how can we find HCF and LCM of numbers. Okay, I have taken example 12 and 18 for this. Okay, now let us find what is the prime factorization of 12 first. Since fundamental theorem deals with prime factorization, you are going to find prime factorization of 12. Okay, what is the prime factorization of 12? 12, 2 6s are 12, 2 3s are 6, and 3 1s are. Yes, so prime factorization of 12 is 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, 2 into 2 into 3. Now what are prime factorization of 18? So it is nothing but 2 9s are 18, 3 3s are 3 1s are. Okay, so it is 2 into 3 into 3. Okay, now to find HCF, I have already explained you in this video that you will check for the common factors. Yes, now 2 is a common factor, so HCF is equal to HCF of 12 and 18 is equal to, now 2 is a common factor, and here you can see that 3 is also a common factor. Yes, so it is 2 into 3, HCF is 6. Okay, now you want to find out least common multiple. So for this also, let us use prime factorization method itself. So here, what do you do? For LCM, now let us rewrite these steps. It is 2 into 2 into 3. Now 18 is 2 into 3 into 3. Okay, this is nothing but 2 into 2 can be written as 2 square. Do you agree? Into 3. Now 18, now this can be written as 2 into 3 into 3 is nothing but 3 square. Yes, now LCM is nothing but the product of the highest power of the common factors. Okay, now you can see that 2 is a common factor in both the numbers. Yes, but highest power of 2 is here. Yes, so highest power of 2 is 2 square. Okay, 2 is common for both the numbers, but the highest power of 2 is where? It is in 12. Okay, it is 2 square. Here it is only 2. 2 means it is 2 power 1. Highest power is this one, 2 square into, now you can see 3 is common in both the numbers, it is a common factor, but the highest power of 3 is in which number? It is here. Okay, so 3 square. So LCM is nothing but it is a product of the highest power of the common factors. Okay, so 2 square is 4 into 3 square is 9. So LCM is 36. Since it is multiples, common multiples, so you will always take the highest common multiple. Okay, just remember with this word, it is least common multiple. So you'll take highest power of the common factors. Okay, and here HCF, it is highest common factor, but you will take the lowest power. Okay, here you will just find the common factors of this and you will just multiply the common factors. Clear? And here you will take the highest power of the common factors. This is what you have learned already in your class 6. Now the other type of problem which you may get from this chapter is, you will be asked, you will be given something like this, an expression like this, and you will be asked whether this is a composite number or not. Okay, so this you will find using fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay, how? You know that fundamental theorem of arithmetic states that a composite number, if x is a composite number, it can be written as product of prime numbers. Okay, so p1 into p2 into p3 into so on. Yes, so it has to be product of prime numbers. Okay, so this also, if we can bring it in the form of product, then we can say that this particular number is composite number. Okay, how do we do that? Here you can see that this is product, this is one term, and here you have a plus. Okay, so we don't want any plus signs in our question. We have to convert it into products. Okay, we want only multiplication. So this is simple logic. So now let us see here. You can see that 13 is common in both the terms. Yes, so here you have a plus sign. So this complete thing is one term and this is one term. Yes, so you can see that 13 is common in these two terms. Yes, so taking 13 as common, what is left out here? If you take 13 common, you are left out with 7 into 11. Yes, so 7 into 11. Okay, and you have a plus, bring down plus here. Yes. And if you take 13 common from here, 13 is nothing but 13 into 1. Yes. So if you're taking 13 common, you're left out with what? With 1. So don't make mistakes here. You have to think that 13 is nothing but 13 into 1, and you don't forget to write 1 here. Okay, so this is nothing but 13 into 7 11s are is 77 plus 1. Okay, so this is nothing but 13 into 77 plus 1 is 78. Okay, now you can see that you have brought this expression in the form of factors, okay, in the form of products. Clear? And also you can factorize 78. Okay, 78 you can divide it by 2, and you can write as 2 into 2 3s are 6 and 9. So you can write as 13 into 2 into 39. Okay, so you can see that this number is a composite number because you are able to express it in the form of factors, prime factors. So whenever a question like this is given to you, you will firstly check if there is anything common in it, and you will take common. Okay, once you take common and solve the brackets, then you can clearly state that that particular number is a composite number. Now my dear students, it's your time to check your understanding with do it yourself. So find the HCF of 270 and 600 using Euclid's division lemma, and also find the LCM of 12, 18, 20. This you can use it prime factorization method to find the LCM. Okay, and also find is this number a composite number or not. So how do you do that? There is something common in this, so take the common term out, and using fundamental theorem of arithmetic you can conclude that this is a composite number. So do it yourself, and that's all for this session, and I would love to hear some feedback from you. So tell me, how did you like this session? Since it is your very first class of class 10, so tell me, how did you like it? Write in the comment section below. Also don't forget to like this video, give it a big thumbs up, and share it with all your friends. Let them also prepare, let them also start the preparation. And also don't forget to subscribe, because you get lot of important information on this channel, and don't miss out any video. So subscribe and do follow this channel. Thanks for watching.